Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Morrowind. Last time, when we left off, we were exploring the city of Sadrith Mora. Let's keep going with that. We were at Thurval Serethi Healer, who turns out to actually be Thurval Serethi. Not that it matters too much. He sells spells, but nothing I actually need, or don't already have. So let's just chat with him. Background, I am Thurval Serethi, healer and oathman of the Great House Telvanni. Okay. I'd like to get into his chest. Success. Good. Let's see if we can nick this comberry. And let's check out his other containers. Really mean to do that. If I seem a little slow, it's because I am, to be perfectly honest, still a little bit drunk from the bender my wife and I ended up going on last night. It was great. It was awesome. You do pay the price the next morning, especially when you get a little bit older like I am. Get all this loose gold, then we can move right along to the next house, which is Urtisa Romaine's house. Alright, let's head in here. Here's Urtisa. Let's speak with her. Welcome to Sadrith Mora, Travis. This is the district seat of House Telvanni. We see many Outlanders here, but Sadrith Mora is not a very friendly town, especially if you're an Outlander. Can I help you find services? Background. I am Urtisa Romaine, commoner. Alright, simple enough. Let's loot out her house. Nothing in here except a teensy bit of gold, but that's alright.
something I can do.
Alright, next is Hlaris Gidrun's house. Let's check it out, shall we? Let's speak with him. Yes, Travis, I'm Hlaris Gidrun. Go ahead, I'm sure you have questions. Background. I am Hlaris Gidrun, commoner. Little advice. Sadrith Mora is the only place to shop for goods and services in the Telvanni district. All the other Telvanni settlements are small, with very few services and very poor selections. Truly nothing on his ground floor. Upstairs, there is a locked chest with a little gold in it. And another locked small chest with a little more. Just gonna try and get over the hammock to get that last sack, but I don't think it's gonna work. I can probably get it airborne like this. And there's nothing I need inside anyway. That's it for his house. Next up is Lalam Madalas, mage. Nope. There he is. He's tucked away back here. Let's go visit him. Alright, stranger. Why are you here in Sadrith Mora? Are you looking for services, or are you trying to find some specific place in town? He won't sell us spells, unless we're a member of House Telvanni. Fair enough. Be doing that soon enough, but let's speak with him in the meantime. Background. I have Lalam Madalas, Nightblade and Spellwright of the Great House Telvanni. Okay, fair enough. Let's check the baskets behind him. He has a copy of Withershins, a restoration skill book we've already read. That's it for now. We'll be back shortly after we actually join House Telvanni by speaking to the mouths. For now, let's head to Volmini Drowl's house. You'll note, you might remember that's the one we've been directed to on our outstanding Imperial Cult Almoner quest. So, let's go over here to Volmini Drawl's house and head inside. We can start.
I can spare a few moments if you care to talk.
With these containers. Not sure there's a good way to get to that last one, and I don't really care. Let's just talk with her instead. Yeah. I'm Volmini Drowl, and this is my home. What do you want from me? Background. I'm Volmini Drowl, commoner. We'll skip all the quest dialogue for now. All right, let's talk to her about Mossanon first. Yes, he is a high elf and he lives here with me. We are very close friends. Embezzled funds. Yes, I'm afraid there's no point in denying it. He was foolish. I've tried to persuade him to return the gold, but he is afraid he'll be sent away from me to rot in a prison in a distant land. Okay. Let's go upstairs. Where there's looting to do. And we can speak to Mossanon himself. Yes, what do you want? Background. I'm Mossanon, trader. As I often do, I will skip the quest dialogue until I do the rest. I don't always remember, but I try to. Mossanon. Yes, I am Mossanon. Let's ask him now about embezzled funds. Yes, I took the 3,000 gold. It was foolish and wrong, but I was in love, and thought that Volmini could only love a rich man. I was wrong and foolish. Now I know she loves me, not my gold. Now I only have 2,500 gold left. I spent the rest. I'll give you the 2,500 gold, and promise to pay back the rest as soon as I can, if you will promise to keep my whereabouts secret from Kenktuni and Ponius. If arrested, I'll be sent back to Cyrodiil for trial and be separated from my precious Volmini. Demand the gold and make no promises. Promise secrecy and take the gold. Take no action and consider the offer. I see no reason not to promise secrecy and take the gold. I think I am a good judge of character. I believe one earns one's character by effort, and I can sense that you have taken the care to build a personality that inspires trust. I will honor your promise. Take the gold, and Volmini and I thank you for keeping our secret. Journal updated, 2,500 gold added. I found Massanon in Sadrith Mora and confronted him about the embezzled funds. He admitted his crime and offered to return 2,500 gold, he had spent the rest, and pay back the rest as soon as he could, if I'd promised to keep his whereabouts secret from Kenktuni and Ponius. I promised to keep his secret. My earnest promise persuaded him to trust me, and he yielded the 2,500 gold to me. Okay, so I'd probably need to see Kenktuni and Ponius, because it's only a 1,000 Drake pledge, and we got 2,500. But next we'll go to Pirlet Rosterard, apothecary. She's right here. Pirlet Rosterard, apothecary. Perfect. There is a guard in here. First shop we've seen. First shop we've gone into where that's the case. We'll have to be a little careful picking this lock. Not a huge deal, though. God damn, I am still drunk. I can't even distinguish between one and Tilde. You can tell when we're dealing with Telvanni. They don't like us much yet. Okay, well, she's in the way of those other sacks, and I don't particularly care. So, let's just speak with her. First time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead. Ask your questions. Background. I am Pirlet Rosterard, apothecary and lawman of the Great House Telvanni. Cure Blight. Yes, I usually have potions of Cure Blight in stock. That seems to be it for her. Let's check upstairs right quick. And we're done here. Alright. one other house in this little cluster. That would be Trendress Drawl's house. Let's go ahead and chat with him. Welcome to Sadrith Morat, Travis. This is the district seat of House Telvanni. We see many Outlanders here, but Sadrith Morat is not a very friendly town, especially if you're an Outlander. Can I help you find services? Background. I am Trendress Drawl's commoner. Excuse me. Okay. Let's loot around his house now. And that's it. Simple enough. Alright. Probably go ahead and do Telnaga next. So while we're at this nice big gap in everything, makes sense to me to go ahead and check out Telnaga. So let's enter the Great Hall. In here, first we find Rirenia Salas. The same to you, Travis. Welcome to Sadrith Mora and House Telvanni country. What brings you to the island? Are you planning to visit some specific place here, or is there anything else I can help you with? Background. I am Rirenia Salas, Battle Mage. Also have Drodos Galen. What do you want in Sadrith Mora, Outlander? Are you looking for someone in particular? Background, I'm Drodos Galen, sorcerer and lawman of the Great House Telvanni. Room, there's a copy of The Horror of Castle Zir. which we've already read. Destruction skill book, if you forgot. Back here, there's an empty Grand Soul gem. Homilies of Blessed Almalexia. The Monomyth. The Affairs of Wizards. The Annotated Anuad. The Black Glove. The House of Troubles. And yes, a little bit of loose gold. And a few exits, too. Let's see, there's an upstairs, a downstairs, or we can stay on this level. There's nothing back here. Let's go downstairs first. Now suddenly we can... Oh, okay. Same thing. If we go downstairs, there's a door back out to Sadrith Mora. Didn't realize there were that many entrances. Okay, that's fine. There's nothing here. Instead, let's head upstairs. Down to a single path. I always like that. And let's enter the Telnaga General Quarters. Let's see what we've got here. Usual beds. And chests. None of which turn out to have anything inside. Let's speak with Vanel Servan. You plan to be in Sadrith Mora long, Outlander? Maybe you'd like a little advice. Background. I'm Vanel Servan, battle mage and lawman of the Great House Telvanni. Goes farther upstairs. Let's check out this bedroom first. There's a copy of the Alchemist's Formulary. Now we can go even further upstairs to speak with Faldan. What do you want in Sadrith Mora, Outlander? Are you looking for someone in particular? Background, I'm Faldan, archer and lawman of the Great House Telvanni. Now let's... head back and jump up to the next level to speak with Berengaval. First time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead, ask your question. Background. I am Berengaval, archer and retainer of the Great House Telvanni. That's it for him. There's nothing else in this room, but we can head to the upper tower. Left, straight, or right? Like straight is actually the only real way to go right now. Got some gold and a final lesson, a copy of the final lesson. Baskets, and then let's speak with Endar Drenim. Alright, stranger, why are you here in Sadrith Mora? Are you looking for services, or are you trying to find some specific place in town? Background. I am Endar Drenim, sorcerer and spellwright of the Great House Telvanni. Okay, let's drop down first, which just leads us to the Great Hall. Instead, we can levitate up. The next level up, there's a locked door to the upper hall. Interesting. I'll unlock it right quick and head up to the top, where there is a trapped, locked door, which I can open. That leads to a storeroom. Alright. What do we got in here? nothing I actually need. Go figure.
You seek information about me?
On this level, we have Ivrami Sarandis. I don't believe I've seen a high elf with such a grand outfit in some time. Can I help you? Background. I am Ivrami Sarandis, Nightblade. To speak to Master Neloth, just head east along the central passage, and mind the central shaft. It's a long fall. Someone in particular. This is Telnaga, the Tower of Master Neloth. The mouths of the other counselors are at Telvanni Council Hall, Imperials are at Wolverine Hall, and Garadhel, Prefect of Hospitality, is at the Gateway Merchant Inn, along with Airy, Gateway's Publican. Cool. So, we've got two more trapped, locked doors here. Let's check them out, shall we? And note that that door leads us back outside. Looks like we got weapons and armor in here. Nothing too awesome, but I will take those silver arrows. Engair. What do you want in Sadrith Mora, Outlander? Are you looking for someone in particular? Background. You may call me Engair. What I do is my own affair. Oops. Okay, there's nothing else in what appears, for all intents and purposes, to be a jail cell. This heads outside with a door to the upper hall. Before we do that, let's head in here to speak with Vares Rerum. First time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead. Ask your question. Background. I am Vares Rerum, battle mage and lawman of the Great House Telvanni. Neloth. Master Neloth is right here. Alrighty.
What?
And let's chat with Neloth. Whatever you want, the answer is no. Gateway, this is not something I would tell the likes of you. House Telvanni, I am Master Neloth, one of the counselors of House Telvanni. If you want to learn more about House Telvanni, speak with my mouth in the Telvanni Council House in Sadrith Mora. He really doesn't like us. Okay, let's go down one level and enter the Telnaga Upper Hall. While we're in here, a copy of the Doors of the Spirit. I'll take those arrows. Biography of Baron Zaya V1. Some frost salts. And then a door outside. Alright. That is it for Telnaga. Let's head back to the loop we were on. Let's go see Balin Vendu, monk. Speak with her. Welcome to our fair town, Travis. If you're new to Sadrith Mora, I'm sure you'll see much that puzzles you. Do you have any questions? Background, I am Balin Vendu, monk. That's it. All right. Here is Meluria Seleth's house. Let's speak with her. Yes, Travis, I'm Meluria Seleth. Go ahead, I'm sure you have questions. Background. I am Meluria Seleth, commoner. annotated NWAD. There's a little gold, but not a whole lot going on in her house. All right, that's it. Next up is Vaden Bellis's house. At least if I can get unstuck, which it seems I might not be able to do without the console. Good lord. Thank you. Next up is Vaden Bellis's house. You can chat with him. Same to you, Travis. Welcome to Sadrith Mora and House Telvanni country. What brings you to the island? Are you planning to visit some specific place here, or is there anything else I can help you with? Background. I am Vaden Bellis, commoner. Gold. Doesn't matter if he spots me. And he has a copy of The Four Suitors of Benita. It for him. So let's head to Urtiso Farion, Sorcerer. Speak with her. What do you want in Sadrith Mora, Outlander? Are you looking for someone in particular? She's got no spells we don't already know, so let's just chant with her. Background. I am Urtiso Farion, Sorcerer and Oathman of the Great House Telvanni. Check her stuff out. Not seeing much. I will take those frost salts. And that's it for this one. fun. Now straight ahead of us, in what still looks like a pretty small pod, is the Morag Tong Guild. So let's speak with Dunsalapal Dun Ahe. Yes, Exalted Master, are you here to see what writs are open? Background. You may call me Dunsalapal Dun Ahe. What I do is my own affair. The writ for Brilnosu Laris has already been executed. The Morag Tong executes justice on murderers when the law cannot or will not. The writ on Galassa Yuvain has been executed. To become the Grand Master of the Morag Tong, you must slay the current Grand Master, Ino Lalu. The writ on Guril Retharen has been executed. Ianeth, I have given this writ to you already, Travis. Mathen Bemis is dead. Mavod Dredib is dead. What could I do for you, brother? You have executed this writ already, Travis. You have already executed the writ on Serene Sadis. Tyra Belvane is dead. Taurus Saren is dead by your hand. Okay, cool. Anybody upstairs? Yes, Alvin Salas. Yes, Travis, I'm Alvin Salas. Go ahead, I'm sure you have questions. Background. You may call me Alvin Salas. What I do is my own affair. There's a copy of the Book of Dawn and Dusk, which we've seen a million of, to be honest. Alright, let's head upstairs to speak with Nemanian Phasian. Welcome to Sadrith Mora, Travis. This is the district seat of House Telvanni. We see many Outlanders here, but Sadrith Mora is not a very friendly town, especially if you're an Outlander. Can I help you find services? He's got no new spells, so we'll just talk to him. Background. You may call me Nemanian Phacian. What I do is my own affair. And we have Vaveli Dralas. Welcome to our fair town, Travis. If you're new to Sadrith Mora, I'm sure you'll see much that puzzles you. Do you have any questions? Background. You may call me Vaveli Dralas. What I do is my own affair. That's it for the Morag Tong Guild, so let's make our way out. And let's proceed. Next is Rolus Garvon's house. Speak with him. Yes, Travis, I'm Rolus Garvon. Go ahead, I'm sure you have questions. Background. I am Rolus Garvon, commoner. Okay, he doesn't really have much to say. Let's check out his house. He is hoarding some moonsugar. Has a bit of a drug habit, apparently. Nick is gold. That's it. Pretty uneventful little house. That's alright. Closing in on finishing now. Next is Nevrila Araloth's house. So, let's go ahead and speak with her. First time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead, ask your questions. Background. I'm Nevrila Araloth. I do a little of this, a little of that. Ah, she's Kamana Tong. Prundy's woman. When we are better friends, ask again. I'm not sure if I can get to those sacks or not. Well, I can get to the top one, but the one way under the stairs and even the bottom one kind of seem impossible. Let's head upstairs first, where we find, I believe, actually some new books. We have not read Charwick Koninga, Volume 4. It's a hand-to-hand skill book. Take it off the book list and read it. Alright. The Charwick Koninga Letters, Book 4. 8 Suns Dawn, 3E412, Anaglyph, Somerset Isle. My good friend Lord Gemin, you must forgive me for not meeting you at the palace personally, but I've been unavoidably tragically detained. I've left the front gate and door unlocked, and if you're reading this, you must have made it at least as far as the antechamber to the east drawing room. Perhaps you've already wandered the estate and seen some of its delights before coming to this chamber. The 7 fountains of marble and porphyry, the reflecting pool, the various groves, the colonnades, and quincunx. I don't think you would have already gone to the second floor suites in the west room and the west wing, as you would have had to pass this room first and picked up this letter. But believe me, they're beautifully appointed, with magnificent balustrades, winding staircases, intimate salons, and bedchambers worthy of your affluence. The price of this property is exorbitant, certainly, but for a man like you who seeks only the best, this is the villa you must have. As you undoubtedly noticed as you arrived through the gates, there are several smaller buildings ideally suited to be guard stations. I know you are concerned with security. I am an intensely greedy man, and there is nothing I would have liked more than to meet you here today, show you the grounds, fawn on you obsequiously, and collect a fat percentage of the cost of the sale when you bought this marvelous palace, as I'm sure you would have. My dilemma that caused my inexcusable absence began shortly after I arrived here early, to make certain the villa was well cleaned for your inspection. A man named Koninga crept up behind me and gripped me by the throat, clamping his left hand over my mouth and nose and throttling me with his right hand, crushing the soft spot on my throat just below the thyroidal cartilage. He effectively strangled me in a few quick but very painful minutes. I am currently buried in a pile of leaves in the North Statuary parterre, close to the exceptional sculptural representation of the transformation of Trinimac. It should not be too long before I am discovered. Someone at my bank will surely notice my absence in due time. Koninga might have buried me deeper, but he wanted to be ready for the arrival of his old partner, Charwick. Perhaps part of you thinks it best to stop reading now, Lord Gemin. You are looking around the antechamber and seeing nothing but doors. The large one you took to come in from the garden is locked now behind you, and without a better knowledge of the layout of the estate, I could not recommend you attempt to flee down a corridor that might easily come to a dead end. No, much better to keep reading and see where this is going. Koninga, it seems, was in a partnership with his friend Charwick to try to recover Azura's star. They understood it to be in the possession of someone named Hadwaf Naithwir, a man who conjured up the Daedra Prince Azura herself to acquire it. As Naithwir originally hailed from High Rock, Charwick went there to look for him while his partner searched Morrowind. They planned to communicate their findings by letters sent through couriers. Charwick's first letter stated that he had found information that Naithwyr had a mysterious patron named Belisir, a fact he had learned at a cemetery with a gravestone of Naithwyr's sister Pereira and a lycanthropic caretaker. Koninga replied back that he could find nothing about Belisir, but believed that Naithwyr had returned to High Rock with Pereira after getting the star. Charwick's last letter was written on his deathbed, having sustained mortal wounds from his battle with Belisir, who it seemed had been a mighty Daedra lord. Koninga grieved for his friend and traveled the span of the Empire to Wayrest to pay his call of condolences on Lady Morling, the woman at whose house Charwick had been staying. After making some inquiries, Koninga learned that her ladyship had left the city quite suddenly. She had been entertaining a guest named Charwick, and it was understood that he died, though no one ever saw the body. Certainly no healers had been sent to her house on the 13th of last year, and no one in Wayrest, just like no one in Telerun, had ever heard of Belisir. Poor Koninga was suddenly unsure of everything. He retraced his late partner's path through Boreane and Grimtree Gardens, but found that the Naithwyr family crypt was elsewhere, in a small town in the barony of Dwynan. There was indeed a lycanthropic caretaker, fortunately in human form at the time. When questioned using the technique of strangulation-release, he told Koninga the story that he had told Charwick many months before. Hadwaf and Pereira Naithwyr had returned to Dwynan, intent on settling old business. As the star requires potent spirits for power, they thought they would begin small by capturing the spirit of the werewolf they knew of in the family graveyard. Sadly for them, their grasp exceeded their reach. When the poor caretaker resumed his human form one morning, he found himself lying next to the shredded, bloody bodies of the Naithwyr siblings. Distressed and fearful, he brought the corpses and all their possessions down into the crypt. They were still there when Charwick came, and so too was Azura's star. Koninga now saw things clearly. The letters he had received from Charwick were lies, intended to keep him away. Undoubtedly with the assistance of Lady Morling, his new partner, he had concocted stories, including one of his own demise, to trick Koninga into abandoning the quest for the star. It was clearly a sad statement on the nature of friendship, and one that needed immediate correction. It took the better part of 6 months for Koninga to find his old partner. Charwick and Lady Morling had used the power of the star to make themselves very wealthy and powerful. They assumed a number of different identities in their travels through High Rock and Skyrim, and then down to Valenwood and the Somerset Isle. Along the way, of course, the star itself disappeared, as great Daedric artifacts always do. The couple still had much wealth, but their love sadly fell on troubled times. When they reached Alanor, they parted ways. One must assume that during their months together, Charwick must have told Lady Morling about Koninga. It's pleasant to think of the loving couple laughing over the stories they were telling him about the mythical and dangerous Belisir. Charwick must not have given his former beloved a very accurate physical description, however, because when Lady Morling, then under the identity of the Countess Xyliana, met Koninga, she had no idea who he was. It came as quite a surprise to her when he began strangling her and requesting information about her former paramour. Before she died, she told Koninga what Charwick's new name and title was and where he was looking for a new palace. She even told him about me. Given all the twists and bends the last month's chase took him on, it was not difficult to find which palace Charwick was looking to buy and what time his appointment was to view it. Then he had merely to arrive early, dispose of me, and wait. There our story must sadly end. I look forward to seeing you soon. Yours, Cyrix Gwynethi, former estate banker. P.S. Charwick, turn around now, or don't. Your choice. Your friend, Koninga. No, I don't think so. Poison Song Book 3 is also a new book, which we'll read and take off the list right now. The Poison Song, Book 3, by Briston Zell. Tay was 18 in the year 685 of the First Era when he first saw Mournhold, the City of Spires, home of the goddess. His cousin Kalkoroth, already a senior initiate in the temple, gave him a couple rooms on the ground floor of the house he had purchased. They were small and unfurnished, but bittergreen grew outside the windows, and when the wind blew, they filled his bedroom with a lovely, spicy air. The chords of the song did not trouble him anymore. Sometimes he was even unconscious to it, so low and melodic it had become. Occasionally, when he was passing through the streets on the way to the temple for his instruction, someone would pass him and the song would rise in intensity before falling away again. Whatever was different about those people, Tay never tried to ascertain. He remembered the last time he had let the song lead him, and called for him to murder his young cousin Vaster. The memory did not trouble him unduly, but he did not want to hurt anyone again unless he had to. House couriers regularly brought Tay letters from Baynara, still back in Sandal House on the island of Gorn. She might have gone to study at the temple, she was certainly intelligent enough, but she chose not to. In a year or two at most, she would have to leave and assume her place in House Indoril, but she was not in a hurry. Tay welcomed the trivial, gossipy news the letters brought, and responded back with news of his own studies and romances. In his third month in Mournhold, he had already met a girl. She was also a student at the temple, and her name was Akra. Tay wrote enthusiastically about her to Baynara, describing her as having the mind of Sotha Sil, the wit of Vivek, and the beauty of Almalexia. Baynara replied back merrily that if she had known how blasphemous students of the temple were allowed to be, she might have become an initiate herself. "You are very devoted to your cousin," Akra laughed when Tay showed her the letter. "Am I looking at the last remains of a thwarted romance?" "She's lovely, but I never thought of her that way," Tay scoffed. "Incest never particularly interested me." "Is she a very close cousin, then?" Tay thought for a moment. "I don't know. Truthfully, no one spoke much of either her parents or mine, so I really don't know how we were connected. They were casualties of the War of the Red Mountain, that I know, and it seemed to cast rather a pall on the adults' humor whenever we asked about her parents or mine. After a while, we stopped asking. But you're an Indoril, too. Perhaps you're a closer cousin to me than Baynara." "Perhaps so," Akra smiled, rising from her chair. She uncoiled her hair, which had been pulled up in the formal arrangement reserved for well-born priestesses. As Tay watched transfigured, she removed the small brooch that fastened her robe to her shoulder cape. The soft silken fabric slipped down slowly, exposing her dark, slender body to him for the first time. "If we are, does incest particularly interest you now?" As they made love, the song began a slow, rhythmic ascension in Tay's head. The vision of Akra before him darkened and was replaced by images from his nightmares before returning again. When finally he collapsed, spent, the room seemed filled with the fiery red clouds of his dream, and the scream of the woman and her child facing death echoed in his head. He opened his eyes, and there was Akra, smiling at him. Tay kissed her, grateful to have her in his arms. For the next 2 weeks, Tay and Akra were never far apart. Even when they were at study in opposite wings of the temple, Tay thought of her, and somehow knew she was thinking of him. They would rush to be together afterwards, ravishing one another in his rooms every night, and in a private corner of the temple garden every day. It was while Tay was rushing to see his beloved one afternoon that the song rose up in powerful, strident tones at the approach of an old, ragged woman. He closed his eyes and tried to quiet it, but when he looked again at her purchasing corkbulb papyrus from a street vendor, he knew who she was, his old nursemaid from Gorn, Edaba, she who had abandoned him without even a farewell to join her family on the mainland. She didn't see him, and as she passed down the street, Tay turned and began to follow. They walked through shadowy passageways into the very poorest part of the city, a quarter which was as alien to him as the wildest principality of Akavir. She unlocked a small wooden door on a street without a name, and he finally called out her name. She didn't turn, but when he followed, he found that the door had been left ajar. The chamber was murky and damp, like a cave. She stood facing him, her face even more wrinkled than he had remembered it, etched with lines of sorrow. He closed the door behind him, and she took his hand and kissed it. "You are so tall and strong," Edaba said, beginning to weep. "I should have killed myself before I let them take me away from you." "How is your family?" Tay asked coldly. "You are my only family," she whispered. "The Indoril pigs forced me to leave, thrusting their blades in my face, when they discovered that I serve you and your family, not them. That bitch girl Baynara saw me at a prayer of mourning." "You're speaking like a madwoman," Tay sneered. "How could you love me and my family but hate the House Indoril? I am of the House Indoril." "You are old enough to know the truth," Edaba said fiercely. Tay had bitterly joked about her madness, but he saw something close to it burning in her ancient eyes. "You were not born of House Indoril. They brought you into their house after the war, like they and all the other houses brought in all the orphans. It was the only way they saw to erase history and remove all traces of their enemies, by raising their enemies as one of them." Tay turned toward the door. "I can see why you were taken away from Gorn, old woman. You are delusional." Wait, Edaba cried, rushing to a musty cabinet. She retrieved from it a glass globe that shimmered with a spectrum of color, even in the chamber's gloom. Do you remember this? You slew that little boy Vaster because he possessed it, and I took it from your room because you were not ready to face the facts of your inheritance and responsibility then. Did you not wonder why this bauble drew you so? Tay gasped, and though he did not want to, he said, I hear a song sometimes. That is the song of your ancestors, of your true family, she said, nodding. You must not fight it, for it is a song of destiny. It will lead you to do what must be done. Shut up, Tay howled. Everything you say is a lie. You're insane. Edaba threw the globe to the ground with all her might, shattering it with a deafening retort. The shards melted into the air. All that was left was a small silver ring, simply wrought with a flat crown. The old woman quietly picked it up and handed it to him while he stood with his back against the door, trembling. This is your inheritance as the bearer of the sixth house. The ring's crown was meant for stamping and sealing official house proclamations. Tay had seen his Uncle Triffith's similar ring, crested with the wing which was the seal of House Indoril. This ring was different, with an insect design which he remembered from the day when Kenna Gefrisi had taught the house heraldry to Baynara and him. It was the symbol of the accursed House Dagoth. The song took over all of Tay's senses. He heard its music, smelled its horror, tasted its sadness, felt its power, and the only thing he could see before him was the flames of its destruction. When he took the ring and placed it on his finger, his mind was not aware of what he was doing. Nor was Tay aware of anything but the song when he removed his dagger from its sheath and thrust it into his old nursemaid's heart. Tay did not even hear her final words when Edaba fell bleeding to the ground and groaned with a blood-streaked smile, "Thank you." When the veil of the song lifted, Tay did not realize at first he was no longer dreaming. Before him had been flames, the very ones that destroyed the home of his birth, and flames were before him again. But they were flames from a fire he had struck outside the crumbling tenement that were already bursting through walls, consuming the body of his old nursemaid. Tay fled through the streets as people began to call for the guards. And there's Poison Song 1, which we have already read. If we go through her other door, we find a cave. Medder Nulan. This is the Tong hideout for sure. Medder Nulan. You plan to be in Sadrith Mora long, Outlander? Maybe you'd like a little advice? Background. I am Medder Nulan, pawnbroker and thug of the Kamana Tong. Okay. Levis Fells. All right, stranger. Why are you here in Sadrith Mora? Are you looking for services, or are you trying to find some specific place in town? Background. I am Levis Fells, savant and thug of the Kamana Tong. Ring of the Wind. So, you found the Ring of the Wind, eh? Good for you. Skullcrusher. A legendary artifact of that name was forged in the first era by the master weaponsmith Hilbengard of Skyrim, enchanted by his partner, the mage Doruk Gusol. The wondrously light in the hand, it is said to strike the mighty blows of a Daedra prince. It was lost in the first era and unreported since then. It was said to bear a curse that would betray anyone who stole it from its creators. And let's check the crate. Nothing important in there. Or the one in the back. And we can chat with Minasi Bhavani. First time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead. Ask your question. Background. I am Minasi Bhavani, thief and thug of the Kamana Tong. Alright. That's it for this one. Next up is Milara Vedran's house. Let's head back here and visit her.
Is there something I can do for you, Arcana?
Yes, Travis, I'm Milara Vedran. Go ahead, I'm sure you have questions. Background. I am Milara Vedran, commoner. Stuff out. Some loose gold on the chest. Doesn't matter if she spots us. Although I do want to make certain of that, because she's the second person who's spotted me in this video. There's nothing under her pillow, and she's done. Alright, we're so close now. Next up is Anis Saloth, alchemist, which you may recall is where we were directed for our first quest for Big Helendi here in Sadrith Mora. Anis Saloth, first time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead, ask your question. Background. I am Anis Saloth, alchemist and retainer of the Great House Telvanni. potion recipe. I wouldn't give out my potion recipes to anyone, no matter who they were. There is a guard here, so we need to be careful. Let's try and get in behind her. We'll check out the more standard containers first. Of course, we'll pick open the merchant chest, which turns out to just have potions in it. We'll have to get these too, but this is potentially tricky. That one's got some frost salts I want. Perfect. Okay. Nothing down here. If we head upstairs, inside a crate are two dispel potion formulas. Let's get one. Let's read it. This can actually come off our book list as well. One unit pearl, one unit moon sugar. Crush pearl to form a powder. Must mean powder. Heat moon sugar until it melts and begins turning brown. Add pearl dust and remove from heat. Cool with water and add to an alembic. Boil the mixture and collect the vapor. Cool. And now, only two buildings left. Let's head to Farah's hole in the wall. We've got Felina Laren. Same to you, Travis. Welcome to Sadrif Mora and House Telvanni country. What brings you to the island? Are you planning to visit some specific place here, or is there anything else I can help you with? Background. I am Felina Laren, Bard. Hrundi's woman. You already know. Hrundi and I are lovers. When he saves up enough money, we're going to move far, far away from here. So when you get here, you can find out she's Hrundi's lover, and you can leverage that to get him to join the Thieves Guild's cause in lieu of boosting his reputation. Not much of a difference, honestly. Let's chat with Tolvoni Serendis. Yes, Travis, I'm Tolvoni Serendis. Go ahead, I'm sure you have questions. Background. I am Tolvoni Serendis, trader. Hrundi's woman. Your journal... Hrundi comes here as often as he can to see Felina Laren. Your journal has been updated. I found out that Felina Laren is Hrundi's lover. There's a room door with a level 50 lock. Might as well go ahead and check that out. even a gold piece. That's it. Let's talk to the bartender, Farah. Good day. I'm Farah, publican of Farah's Hole in the Wall here in Sadrith Mora. We rent beds, and I have a limited selection of goods for barter. If you're new here, I can also tell you where to look for other services or a specific place nearby. If you're looking for someone in particular, I may be able to help. Background. I am Farah, publican. Beds. No, I don't need the bed. Thank you for offering. That's it for her. Let's head downstairs now. Brallion, remember, is actually the target of our current Balmalagmer quest. There's no real loot here. Let's talk to Tedril Vandrum. Good day to you, Travis. I'm Tedril Vandrum. I assume you're new to Sadrith Mora, since we've never spoken before. I know most everyone in town. Can I help you find someone in particular? Background. I am Tedril Vandrum, commoner. Latest rumors. You have to understand Telvanni Council politics. No one likes Archmagister Gothran. But no one gets to vote for Telvanni Archmagister either. The Telvanni Archmagister only changes when someone kills the old Archmagister, and there's no one in a position to challenge him now, not even close. We've got Redina Othrin. Welcome to our fair town, Travis. If you're new to Sadrith Mora, I'm sure you'll see much that puzzles you. Do you have any questions? Background. I am Redina Othrin, Witch Hunter. He's the target of our Balmalagmer quest. Remember, we need to get his ring. Ho there, Outlander. Are you here to buy slaves? Slavery is quite legal in these parts, you know. Can I help you find someone in particular? Were you hoping for directions to services? Background. I am Brallion, smuggler. Skip the quest dialogue for now. Slavery. The Dark Elves have traditionally permitted enslavement of humans, orcs, Argonians, and Khajiit, and mistreatment of these races is not recognized as a crime, other than as a crime against property. Slavery is not now practiced in Somerset Isles or Valenwood, and its practice is on the wane in Morrowind. By terms of the armistice, Morrowind defines its own laws and customs, and slavery remains legal. Slavery is uncommon in Redoran and Hlalu districts, common in Telvanni, Indoril, and Dress districts. Okay, let's ask him about his ring. Hey, you like it? One of my slaves tried to buy his freedom with it. Imagine, a slave with a jewel like this? He obviously stole it, so I relieved him of its burden. If it has caught your fancy, I could part with it for, say, 1,000 coin. 500 and you have a deal. Too rich for me. Suit yourself. I think we can just pickpocket it off of him. Brallion's exquisite ring. We sure can. Not that it's necessarily easy to do, but... There we go. We've got that. And now, the only building left is the Telvanni Council House. Let's head there and finally join up with a great house, shall we? Telvanni Council House entry. Alright. We've got Deline Arvel. What do you want in Sadrith Mora, Outlander? Are you looking for someone in particular? Background. I am Deline Arvel, mage and hireling of the Great House Telvanni. Join House Telvanni. You must speak with one of the mouths. Mouth. The Telvanni mouths are in the main council house. Someone in particular. All the Telvanni mouths and most Telvanni service providers are here. Counselor Mage Lord Master Neloth lives in Tel'Naga, the wizard tower at the center of town. Heads of the Imperial Guilds and Cult are at Wolverine Hall. At Garadhel, Prefect of Hospitality is at the Gateway Merchant Inn, along with Eri, Gateway's publican. It's simple enough. That's an entrance to the Telvanni Council House. Before we head there, let's just make sure we've explored everything else. Upstairs is another entrance. Downstairs is Telvanni Council House Chambers. Over here to the right, there's a copy of 2920 Frostfall. We've got Nelso Selenim. First time in Sadrith Mora, it shows. We'll go ahead, ask your question. We can buy the spell Stormhand. Alright, let's dialogue with her now. Abolitionist background. I am Nelso Selenim, mage and oathman of the Great House Telvanni. We've also got Galar Rothan. Despite looking like a unique name, Peacemaker is not a unique weapon. First time in Sadrith Mora? It shows. Well, go ahead, ask your question. Hang on, I'm Galar Rothan, enchanter and lawman of the Great House Telvanni. Latest rumors. Lunella Hlerin said she wanted to incorporate some of the defenses she's seen in Dwemer Ruins into her next stronghold. Cool. His name, Galar Rothan. All right. Down here in the other room, we have Mirasso Saren. Welcome to our fair town, Travis. If you're new to Sadrith Mora, I'm sure you'll see much that puzzles you. Do you have any questions? Background. I am Mirasso Saren, enchanter and initiate of the temple. Okay, that's it for her. There's another brown book of 3E426. Special flora of Tamriel. Just about got stuck there. There in just a second. I do want his gold. Tendris Vedran. The same to you, Travis. Welcome to Sadrith Mora and House Telvanni country. What brings you to the island? Are you planning to visit some specific place here, or is there anything else I can help you with? Background. I am Tendris Vedran, apothecary and initiate of the temple. Lot of topics, but no new info. Let's check out the chambers. Let's go to this little side room first. We can speak with Floris Ferrano. Welcome to the Sadrith Mora Temple. No, we are not Telvanni wizards. Look, I wear the vestments of the temple, though I understand your confusion. It is rather dark in here, and cramped, and it certainly doesn't look like a temple, does it? But we do offer the standard temple services here. Background. I am Floris Ferrano, monk and acolyte of the temple. Latest rumors. Watch out for Mistress Thorana. She's eccentric and unpredictable. Okay, that's it for him. And Galero Andarum. Welcome to our Little Elm Civi Chapel. Pardon our informal surroundings, but we are guests here of House Telvanni, and apparently they have no more spacious, well-lit accommodations available for the temple faithful. Still, we have all the services you'd expect to find a much larger temple. She does have a spell. Resist shock. Which we'll go in by. Background. I am Galero Andarum, healer and curate of the temple. Services. Nerus Ferris is a priest, Galero Andarum is a healer, and Floris Ferrano is a monk. And of course you may receive blessings from the Tribunal Shrine here, just as you can in temples and other holy places. Okay. Behind her is just an unlocked chest. If we head to the next room, we can refill our magicka and chat with Nerus Ferris. Welcome to the Sadrith Mora Temple, Outlander. You'll excuse the improvised furnishing, Telvanni hospitality, but I assure you there's nothing second class about our commitment to Elm City or our commitment to faith and service. He also has spells, but nothing new. Let's just speak with him then. Background. I am Nerus Ferris, priest and initiate of the temple. Latest rumors. Mistress Thorana's having trouble with her slaves again. She has more trouble with her slaves than other Telvanni. Nine Divines. Many foreigners worship the Nine as gods. They have divine power like the Daedra, but they are not worthy of worship. Some are better than others, but none are trustworthy. Ordinators. The Order of War fights the enemies of the temple. Most war ordinators are stationed near Red Mountain. Telvanni hospitality. As an outlander, you may not know that House Telvanni is rather casual in its commitment to the Tribunal Temple and its teachings, an unfortunate consequence of the wizard's preoccupation with power for its own sake, and not as a means to better the physical and spiritual well-being of the people. In fact, we are lucky they were willing to grant us these cramped dark chambers. For many years, we had neither shrine nor blessings nor temple staff here in Sadrith Mora. Okay. Let's turn him away from the shelves here, so we can check everything out. There's nothing new, so let's continue into the Hermitage. This is certainly strange. We can make our way down and check out the water. I'm not convinced there's actually anything here. But we do have one person to chat with, and that's Lunella Laren. What are you here for? Do you have a question? Perhaps you wish to join House Telvanni? Advancement. Do you wish to join House Telvanni? You must do this before you can receive advancement. Background. I am Lunella Laren, enchanter and wizard of the Great House Telvanni. Ah! Yes, you may be a worthy candidate. Would you like to join? Yes, I want to join. Alright, moment of truth, let's do it. Are you certain? Remember that once you join, you cannot join any other great house. Perhaps you would like to hear our rules? Hear the rules of House Telvanni. We trust all members of House Telvanni to use their own judgment. If you steal from another Telvanni but still live, then clearly you deserve whatever you've stole. Murdering your opponents by magic or treachery is the traditional way of settling disputes. If you win, then clearly your argument has more merit. You may be expelled, as in any other great house, but most Telvanni will not care or even know about it. Does this appeal to you? Yes, I am eager to join. You are now a member of House Telvanni. Welcome, hireling Travis. When you are ready, speak with me about your chores and your advancement in House Telvanni. Advancement. You have the skills we seek, but you have not done enough chores for House Telvanni. All right. You are already a member of House Telvanni, hireling. Mouth. I am not a mouth for anyone. I oversee the construction of strongholds and bases for House Telvanni. If you have business with House Telvanni, speak with one of the mouths in the Telvanni Council House. Requirements. House Telvanni seeks candidates of high intelligence and dominant will. We value the arts of magic, mysticism, conjuration, illusion, alteration, and destruction. We also expect members to be capable of enchanting items. Enchanting items. Enchanting items is expensive, and failure destroys the item, so enchanting items is most profitable for skilled enchanters. Stronghold. I cannot build you a stronghold until you have been appointed as the mouth of one of the Telvanni counselors. Okay. Telvanni counselors. Here's a recent edition of the Brown Book of Great House Telvanni. It lists the current Telvanni counselors and their residences. Let me mark the locations of the counselors' towers on your map. Telarun, Telvos, Telmora, Telbrenora. And Telnaga is right in the center of Sadrith Mora. Brown Book of 3E426 added. Your journal has been updated. I don't need the book. I can drop it off. Let's check out our new faction. Great House Telvanni. Hireling. I can't believe it, but we've actually been going nearly 2 hours. So I think I'll have to end the video before actually speaking with the mouths and getting our first round of quests. That's okay. Great House Telvanni, hireling. Next rank, retainer. Favorite skills, mysticism, conjuration, illusion, alteration, destruction, enchant. Need one skill at 10. Seems easy enough. Now we can exit the hermitage. Cut back through the chambers. Oh yeah, my journal. I have been given a recent edition of the Brown Book of Great House Telvanni. It lists the current Telvanni councillors and their residences. Back to the entry. And finally, we can head to the actual Telvanni Council House. Now, there are several people to chat with here, as you can see. I do want to check on something right quick. I know there was that upstairs entrance. It looks like... It just leads to this balcony. Alright. I can go ahead and talk to the mouths. So this is Felisa Ulesen. She's up first. I am Felisa Ulesen, the mouth for Mistress Thorana. Chores. Mistress Thorana has requested that someone deliver her new clothes to her. I will pay 1,000 drakes to anyone willing to deliver her new clothes. Take this skirt and deliver it to Mistress Thorana. She lives in Tel Brenora and can be eccentric at times. Take these Almsivi intervention scrolls. Don't hesitate to use them if Thorana becomes difficult. Your journal has been updated. Thorana's skirt and 2 Almsivi intervention added to your inventory. Gateway. Join House Telvanni. You are already a member of House Telvanni, hireling. Mistress Thorana. She is my patron in House Telvanni, and I am her mouth. She can be difficult at times. Be very careful if you must speak with her. Mouth. I am a mouth in House Telvanni. I speak the words of my patron here in the Telvanni Council. New clothes. I gave you the skirt. Deliver it to Mistress Thorana in Tel Brenora. You have to deliver it to her personally, not just put it somewhere in Tel Brenora. Tel Brenora. Tel Brenora is Thorana's tower. It's near the southeast tip of Azura's coast on an island. I will mark it on your map. I believe you can take a boat there. That's probably the best way. Okay. Journal. Mouth Felisa Ulesen gave me some new clothes and asked me to deliver them to Mistress Thorana in Tel Brenora. Mistress Thorana is eccentric and I should be careful not to offend her. And the quest is House Telvanni, new clothes. Good times. Let's chat with the next mouth. That would be Raven Omain. I am Raven Omain, mouth of Mistress Dratha. Chores. Dainali Dren, Mistress Dratha's alchemist, needs 5 portions of muck. Muck. Yes, I am looking for 5 portions of muck. Many alchemists sell it, and you can gather it yourself from muck sponge. Once you have 5 portions of muck, bring them to me. Your journal has been updated. Okay. Mouth Raven Omain asked me to bring her 5 portions of muck for potions of cure disease. And the quest is House Telvanni Muck. Pretty simple. Next. next we have Malum Ryan. I am Malum Ryan, the mouth of Archmagister Gothryn. Yes, Archmagister Gothryn is my patron. If you have business with him, you may find him in Tel'Arun. Chores. Archmagister Gothryn has some questions for Baladus Demnavani. Will you speak with Baladus and ask him 3 questions? Your journal has been updated. Disappearance of the dwarves. Yes, this is one of the 3 questions I want you to ask Baladus Demnavani. Dwemer artifacts. Yes, this is one of the 3 questions I want you to ask Baladus Demnavani. Dwemer language. Yes, this is one of the 3 questions I want you to ask Baladus Demnavani. Nissus. It's a large enough town, Travis. You ought to know where it is, even if you are an outlander. If you want, you can have the Mages Guild teleport you to Aldrun, and then you can take a Siltstrider. Vos, you can take a boat there. That's the easiest way. 3 questions. Baladus Demnavani lives in Arvsdrellin, which is in Nissus. You can use the Mages Guild teleport service to get to Aldrun, and then take a Siltstrider there. Go there and ask him about the disappearance of the dwarves, Dwemer artifacts, and the Dwemer language. You do not have to get an answer from him. Simply asking the 3 questions is enough. Your journal has been updated. Mouth Malum Ryan mentioned something about asking Baladus Demnavani 3 questions. Mouth Malum Ryan wants me to ask Baladus Demnavani about the disappearance of the dwarves, Dwemer artifacts, and the Dwemer language. Mouth Malum Ryan warned me that Baladus may not answer the questions. This is acceptable. I need only ask the questions and return. Okay, this quest is called House Telvanni, 3 questions for Baladus Demnavani. Two more mouths to talk to. That would be Arara Uvulus. I am Arara Uvulus, the mouth of Master Neloth. Chores. Master Neloth needs 5 portions of slowed soap. Gateway Haunting. I inspected the manifestations in the south turret bedchamber of the Gateway Inn. I examined the site thoroughly, but I found no evidence of a restless spirit or ancestral influences. The ghost itself is trivial and easily banished, but I don't know why it reappears or how to stop the reappearances. I can't be sure, but my experience and intuition tells me that a conjuration expert is involved. By that, I mean a mage skilled at summoning ghosts. That's all I can tell you. Your journal has been updated. Conjuration expert. A mage skilled at conjuration is adept at summoning otherworldly creatures, including ghosts. Latest rumors. Skink in Tree's Shade seems like a decent sort for an Argonian, but he has an unhealthy interest in vampires. Master Neloth. Yes, he is my patron, and I represent him on the Telvanni Council. Master Neloth lives in the Tower of Tel'Naga, here in Sadrith Mora. What do you want? Slowed Soap. Yes, Master Neloth needs 5 portions of slowed soap to help with his research. Here are 500 drakes. You can keep what is left after you purchase the slowed soap. Your journal has been updated. 500 gold added to your inventory. Cool. So let's check our journal. I spoke with Arara Uvulus, Master Neloth's mouth, who came to inspect the south turret bedchamber when the gateway haunting manifests. She says she can find no evidence of a restless spirit or ancestral influences. Banishing the ghost is easy, but she doesn't know why it reappears or how to stop it. She suspects that a conjuration expert is involved, someone skilled at summoning ghosts. Mouth Arara Uvulus asked me to acquire 5 portions of slowed soap. That quest is House Telvanni, slowed soap. And let's chat with the final mouth, and then I really need to end the video. We're over 2 hours now. Gallos Mathendus. I am Gallos Mathendus, the mouth of Master Arion. Chores. Master Arion wants a message delivered to Divaith Fear. Would you carry this coded message? Coded message. My patron, Master Arion, wants this coded message delivered to Divaith Fear. He lives in Tel Fear. You might need some help getting there. Why not take these potions of water walking, and these potions of healing, and perhaps a few potions of swift swim as well? If Divaith Fear responds to this message, please deliver his response back to me. Journal updated. 15 potions. And message from Master Arion added to inventory. Divaith Fear. He lives in Tel Fear. He is one of the oldest and most respected wizards in House Telvanni, though he shows an unfortunate lack of interest in politics. To get to Tel Fear, you'll have to swim or fly southwest from Sadrith Mora. It's a long trip. Perhaps I should mark Tel Fear on your map. Master Arion. Master Arion is my patron. He lives in the new Telvanni city of Tel Vos. Tel Vos. Master Arion's tower is near Vos. Take a boat to Vos and head west. Cool. Journal. Mouth Gallos Mathendus asked me to deliver a coded message to Divaith Fear in Tel Fear. And that quest is House Telvanni. Coded message. Let's read the message before I forget it's in my inventory. Message from Master Arion. Looks like it's in the Daedric alphabet. Interesting. But we can take that off of our book list. We can leave the council house. And we can end this video here. This has been Let's Play Morrowind. We have finished exploring Sadrith Mora, and we're now ready to do a good deal of questing. We'll get started next time on Let's Play Morrowind. Until then, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy my videos, please consider clicking an ad, liking, sharing, or subscribing, any or all of which will really help me out. But regardless, please know that I really do appreciate the time you spend watching, and hope you have a fantastic day. Bye.